Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to a GameStar presentation. Tonight, we have the grand final in the Gold Coast tournament, which is hosted by the guys over at League of Legends Oceania. So if you want to see more events like this in the future, we'll put up their Facebook link in the post that we put on the GameStar Facebook, so make sure you go over and like them. So, this will be a best of three that we have here. My name is Coldblood, and I will be doing this game by myself. If we're lucky, we could have I Am Woodsy's girlfriend joining me for the second game, if she's up to it. She has never played League of Legends by the sound of things, so it'll be good fun once we get into that. And, of course, it says Klingo down the bottom, but I am solo casting. And a reminder, we do black out the summoners, just in case the players are being a bit sneaky, trying to see what the other side's running beforehand. We do not allow that, of course. So you're very welcome to talk in the Twitch chat, guys. Just we don't put up with Donga spam unless it's in good faith. I can't remember what we had spamming before, but it was in good faith. So quick shout out to Violet, who is the best Diana in New Zealand. Glad that they are tuning in, and shout out to Spratter13, Identikit, Leha69, who unfortunately, is playing a game and unfortunately cannot be casted, and Leah may be casting with me later on, so that would be awesome, and a shout out to Blakex, who is saying Go Maka, who in this game will be, he told me how to pronounce it, Idiot TQ. It looks like Idiot Q to me, but he said it's Hang on, we even have it in the chat here. It's pronounced Idiotech. Okay, Idiotech. So it is Maka, don't be confused, but he is called Inotech in here. And party and yes, says Maka, better pick Anivia. He was hovering over it when we were playing the intro, but he has picked up the black man himself, Lucian, and they also have the Zyra and the Elise. It's surprising that OG Kush, who are of course on the right hand side here, have allowed the Zyra to go through. Sunwhite is a very talented Zyra player, and I'm surprised that they allowed him to have that pick. And then Elise, we can assume, is going into the jungle, has been very, very popular in the LCS promotion tournaments. She has fantastic clearing. She's got, even if she's behind, she puts out a lot of damage. If she's ahead, she just will penetrate all of your magic resist and just be a tanky pain in the behind. And then, of course, her spiderlings can tank up the jungle and the dragon and whatnot for her. The Zyra Lucian lane, of course, Lucian is the most powerful AD carry at the moment. The only AD carry that can really stand up to him in lane is Jinx, which we can see has been picked up on the other side. I'm trying to remember who the AD carry is. I have a feeling it's Sona Lisa, and he or she is a very talented AD carry. I know that the AD carry for OG Gaming is incredibly talented. I'm just trying to remember who it was. But yeah, we can expect that to go quite well for them. They're going to go for the J4 and the Kennen, so a little bit of the Season 3 coming in here. Kennen has not been picked up in a little bit since the preseason's come out, but I can imagine with the blade weaving and the spell weaving and the offense tree, which we might just have a quick look at. I'm not sure if Grandpa Cyril will be the one playing, but spell weaving and blade weaving gives you more damage on your attacks when you cast a spell, and then more damage with your spells when you cast attacks. I can imagine Kennen would be very strong there as well. Looks like Shyvana is going to be locked in as well. Maka was looking at the Shyvana as well as the Anivia before he picked up the Lucian. But it will go over to the other side, and we don't know where it's going at the moment. We'll have to find out soon. And Leona Jinx, that is a very scary combo for, particularly for Zyra, who's very, very squishy. They purposely made Zyra when she came out. She's got very low movement speed and very low defenses. So if she gets jumped on, she will be in a heck of a lot of trouble. Shout out to Tal, who's saying Go Maka. So we got the New Zealand fan club in here. The ever-present Maka fan club is now known as Idiotech. Yeah, sweet, I got it. So Idiotech will be Maka. And they may be swapping around their champs here, which would be interesting. I know Grandpa Cyril is a very strong mid laner for OG Kush. And he will indeed be taking The, where is the blackout? There we go. He will be taking the cannon into the mid lane. You normally see him abusing the melee at top, but against Renekton, it can be quite difficult for him. And if it had been, or if it had been Elise, he has a lot of trouble in there too. So it's pretty decent that they will be sending cannon into the mid. And Shyvana struggles a little bit against Renekton early on, but once she picks up some levels, her base damages pick up to the state where she will be absolutely fine. Go Macca, he is our man. If he can do it, no one can. That's Macca himself saying that. Called Macca in the Twitch chat. It's a really annoying name. Macca, if you're watching right now, if you're watching the VOD, I hate you for changing your name. Idiotech, okay. I'm going to try and remember that one. So we will have the J4 heading into the jungle, which I'm happy about. When I was trying to climb out of silver, I abused the fact that Jarvan is a fantastic champion, and he's only gotten stronger with the preseason changes. It's just that, other champions have become a whole heck of a lot more viable, at least definitely the most popular jungler at the moment. We're seeing the resurgence of Mundo in the top lane, as you can't kill Mundo with things like Renekton and Shyvana. They just don't pack enough burst to take him down, with Renekton restricted by his high cooldowns, and Shyvana is not known for burst. She's more of a sustained mixed damage fighter. In the mid lane, we will have Ahri versus Kennen. Both of those rely on hitting skill shots to set up their CC. Of course, Ahri's is packed onto the skill shot itself. Idiot Q is, yeah, I agree with the guys in the Twitch chat. Party N, and Blake X. We'll just call Macca Idiot Q. That'll do. And a shout out to XX Cub, who is in the club, apparently. There's people trying to add me, whatever. That was actually happening. I was watching the, what was it? Something that Joe Miller and that American guy were casting. It was, I know Ocelot was playing. It was SK versus some Dream Team with Shocks on it. And he got spam messaged when they found out that he hadn't turned the notifications off. And I've never had that happen before. I'm sure it'd be someone in the chat who's doing that. Yeah, it is Spratter, who was the first person to speak. So Mendrix has gotten his Renekton, and a lot of comfort picks for Tang and friends here. They've got a lot of champs that they like. Macca is normally the jungle, but he will be going AD carry this game. McNugget XD, normally AD carry, will be in the jungle. I believe I Am Woodsy played a really strong Draven in Tang and friends' previous game in this tournament. This is, of course, the grand final, and there will be three games. I think I've already mentioned that. As Identikit is going to add me as well, just as we go to get into the game, so I'll have to see what teams are bringing along the best skins. And we're expecting a lot of early aggression out of both of these teams, even though getting a first blood isn't nearly as good as it was in Season 3 due to decreased spawn times early on and reduced first blood bounty, for the first 4 minutes anyway. It's both of these teams very aggressive early on, and in this tournament particularly, which is hosted by the League of Legends Oceania guys, there's been a lot of fighting early on, even though we don't normally see it. So now into the skin battle, we can see Foxfire Ahri, which is with the champions that are supposed to be about the internet browsers. So there's Safari, Caitlyn, Chrome, Rammus, Foxfire Ahri, and there's one I'm missing, Explorer Ezreal, but no one likes Ezreal. And I'm pretty sure, like, everyone in the world knows that they're based on browsers, but whatevs. We'll have Iron Scale Shyvana. That's my best friend in real life's favorite skin. He loves the Shyvana. There's no actual other skins on OG Gaming, or OG Kush, they will be in this game. And I just actually realized that I don't think I changed the overlay, so I might just do that super duper quickly. Sorry, guys, I've been very, very busy today. It's getting close to Christmas, and very, very annoying to put up with family. I'm sure that's shared by a lot of people out there. They reckon there's more. The cops are the busiest in December because all the families are with each other. And that's what my nana was saying anyway. There's a heck of a lot of problems that happen. So we'll quickly be fixing this up. OG Kush. And the score is 0-0 right now. We'll have a look at the level 1 power of both teams. Looking at Tang and friends lineup up the top, they do have a very strong level 1. They've got the cocoon, they have Oh, Renekton's W always escapes me. They got Charm, they have the Grasping Roots, and Lucian's Piercing Light does a lot of damage as well, so they have a huge amount of utility at level 1, whereas for the other team, Jinx's ability is all pretty decent at level 1. Jarvan can provide vision, but apart from that, nothing on their team strikes me as being particularly strong early on, so if we do see aggression, I would expect it out of Tang and friends engaging the enemy in their jungle. Shout out to Black as Girlfriend, who's going for Maka. Maybe that's Maka's girlfriend, or I'm not actually sure if Maka's male or not. So it may be Maka himself on a different account, who knows. Finally into the game here, we're going to have a pause. We'll turn the chat on to find out what is indeed happening as we fix these up down here. The players never like to actually pick in the order, as Kennen's game has crashed. So waiting for Grandpa Cyril to get back in. And, Blake, I do indeed take special guest casters. If you would like to cast with me, let me know. Normally, we only go GameStar casters, but everyone in GameStar is busy today as December. Of course. Well, one of our casters is playing Renekton at the moment in this very game, so it's Coldblood hates streaming us because it's never-ending pauses. That is very true. I'm Wuzzy's hit the nail on the head here. We aren't here to game-only talk. Maka equals Mackenzie equals girl, says Party N, Party N. And we've looked at the level 1 capability of both teams, and actually it looks like we will be resuming here. So, I'm just waiting to see if Blake wants to cast with me. We will go through both of the teams. Hopefully I've set the overlay up properly. There we go. So, for Tang and Friends in this first game, we will have Idiot Q, who is, of course, otherwise known as Maka. We have Sunwa on the Zyra. We have McNugget XD on the Jungle Elise. And, of course, he did finish gold, so he got the skin. Mendrix will be on the Renekton. Still has not picked up a skin, despite playing Renekton in every single game I see him in. And I Am Woodsy will be the Foxfire Ahri, starting off with the Doran's Ring. And we'll go over OG Kush, who are very talented themselves, so we're expecting a very good game here. Oh, we forgot about the utility of the Volatile Spiderling. It does indeed grant a little bit of vision, and Elise likes to start with the W when in the jungle. So, Beast will be the Shyvana up at the top, who is currently minding the blue with her team, both teams being very conservative. Little Vayne will be on the Leona. Her partner in crime will be Sona Lisa on the Jinx. We expect a lot of action down there. Both supports very, very aggressive. We have Grandpa Cyril in the mid as the Keenan, the Electric Rat. And Bruce V will be the J4. We have seen him on Lee Sin, and he was very, very scary. So I wouldn't be surprised to see him pulling off a lot of strong ganks. Actually decided to go for the Dragon Strike over the Demacian Standard, which I'm not sure why he's done that. Maybe he predicted an early fight and just wanted to have that damage and armor shred, as a lot of the damage in the level 1 fights is auto attack damage, of course. So we have both junglers starting at the bottom parts of their jungle. We'll have to see if they head on over to the Wraiths and then to the top buff for them both. In the mid, of course, we do have Kennen and Ahri. Kennen is a little bit longer range than the Ahri, of course. Grandpa Cyril, does he have any AD? No, it looks like he has gone for the AP. He actually started Doran's Shield, which will allow him to survive a little bit longer against the Elise and the Ahri should he get ganked. Of course, the pause comes out because Tang and friends are in the game. And and now the blue team are going to call a pause. Up at the top, of course, we have Renekton versus Shyvana. They're two brick walls who will be butting heads for a lot of the laning phase. We expect Beast to have a little bit of trouble. And we could see Bruce V head up, but Mendrix is known for turning 1v2 or 2v1 ganks into a double kill for himself on the Renekton. So they would have to be very careful there. You don't pronounce knife can knife there for its Idiot Q. Okay. So waiting for the blue team to be ready down in the bot. We have Lucian and Zyra, which is a lot of burst, versus Jinx and Leona, which is even more burst, but they do lack range. So we'll have to see how it goes for the McNugget XD. Going to be making his way over to the blue buff. Does not have the repel, so can't jump over. But taking the neurotoxin and the venomous bite, probably a little bit better off. Bruce V going to be using the smite on the red now. Has the double buff. McNugget XD working his way into it. Not using the spiderlings to tank because he normally is AD carry, of course, not jungle. And shout out to Jakey, who is the jungler for Doge for LOL, who is saying that Noob Woodsy pauses to watch the stream and chat. Sona Lisa taking a lot of damage here. We can see the Xanath Blade going to land by Little Vayne, but a lot of damage going to go back on top of him, and the trade at the bottom lane leaving both AD carries very low, and actually there's a huge engage in the top part of the jungle. I can't believe I missed that one. We're going to jump back 30 seconds and figure out what exactly happens here. So we're going to have the Elise finishing off the blue, the aforementioned Bruce V coming in, and it looks like they both wanted some blood at the top lane here. They're both going to catch sight of each other. Can't remember who ended up getting the first blood. It may have been Shyvana. Bruce V going to be locked up in the cocoon, but then jump onto McMugget XD, who will dodge the combo. Ignite goes off onto Bruce V, and that will be Mendrix picking up the double buff. Both top laners actually going to pick up double buff for themselves. Mendrix going to flash forward, but of course is down on cooldowns. Beast going to try and delay for the burnout cooldown to come up, which it does successfully do. Is Slice and Dice available for Mendrix? It is indeed. Going to get off the W, but actually flash away by Beast, and the Dice takes him a little bit close under there. So all of the cooldowns blown for the top lane as they both walk away with double buff. Mendrix, of course, going to be sitting very fine with the sustain from Cull the Meek. Ruthless Predator. I have to try and get that in my head. That's what Renekton's W is called. I always try and think, I go to say slice and dice, but it's like, wait a second, he is slicing and dicing, but, Blake is the AD carry. You need a more distinctive name, I think, Blake. Blake, if you add me on Skype, Quornby2, I'll type it in the chat, I'll get you into cast this game with me. I'll just type it in the chat there, so add me, Blake. If anyone else adds me, I will decline it. And we can see the gang down by McNugget XD in the bottom lane, not going to be the most successful. In the mid lane, we can see Bruce V waiting off to the side. Iron Woodsy being very smart and staying the heck back. Grandpa Cyril going to be jumping forward. Nice charm. Going to negate the lightning rush damage, but the knock-up will go off Iron Woodsy. I think he will be okay here. Going to flash away and get the ignite onto Bruce V, which does force him away. So well played there by Iron Woodsy to escape that one. It was a nice charm. Bruce V actually falling lower and lower to McNugget XD. But Grandpa Cyril will be able to pick that one up in the end. So unfortunate for the Tang and friends. Only 200 gold behind at this point. Waiting for Blake to add me so he can come and cast with me. And we'll have a look at the CS. So up the top, Mendrix is sitting pretty with the chain vest. Going to be going for Sunfire Cape. Of course, Shyvana's damage, a lot of it is magic. Particularly since he is leveling the burnout. It's that is Shyvana's niche. She's a mixed damage fighter. So Chain Vest not going to be as effective as you'd think against an auto attacker, but it will definitely hurt the Jarvan and his damage output. Shout out to 4Geek and Wreck Game, who I believe are also on Doge for LOL. Can't remember their positions right now, of course. But yeah, I'm glad they have tuned in. And down at the bottom lane, we can see the CS lead is in Sona Lisa's favor by a little bit. The experience looks like it is in the blue team's favor, but that would be because they're pushing and now it is all equaled up. Mid lane is fairly close, honestly, as well. The CS is looking very close across the board. That kill has only put OG Kush about 200 in the lead, so this is certainly anyone's game still. Trinket Ward in the River Brush is just going to time out there, and we can see the engage onto Leona. She will not live for very long. Did she manage to pop the Eclipse? No, so she was very, very squishy. Didn't even have the Relic Shield for a little bit of health, had the Relic Coin. Of course, Talisman of Ascension is incredibly strong, but Leona does like the health, and it looks like they, or the blue team, are going to go straight for the dragon. At 300 gold lead, Tang and friends looking to pick the dragon up, but Bruce V does not want to let that happen for free. He's going to get the ward off. Can he get the smite steal in? Smiting a little bit early by McNugget XD, but Sunwa will be able to secure that one. Idiot Q going to jump up with the Relentless Pursuit, but is out of margin. mana, can't do much else. Charm will land, and the mana bars of Tang and Friends looking fairly low, whereas the Resourceless Cannon going to be on his way with the Slicing Maelstrom available. Sunwa forced to flash away from the Flame Chompers of Sona Lisa. Meanwhile, we can see Iron Woodsy not going to be happy with running into the Cannon there. Pops the Slicing Maelstrom and easily picks that one up. Big Nugget SD finally using the Spiderlings to tank up the wave. And we can see Bruce V still down here, whereas the Elise is on her way out. Sunwa, will he get jumped on here, or are they going to go for Lucian? McNugget XD coming back in to support. They want to dive on Macca here, who is Idiot Q, but the minions have now run out for them, and they're in a little bit of trouble. Cocoon did already go out, though, and the mana bar for McNugget XD looking fairly low itself. So after Dragon and a kill picked up by Tang and Friends, Iron Woodsy gonna fall in the part of the jungle, and 600 gold will be in Tang and Friends' favor when all is said and done. How about the tower? It's still looking fairly healthy. Will McNugget XD stick around to try and stop the tower damage, where Sona Lisa is pushing as hard as he can? Nomad's Medallion is on the Leona now, so her damage output going to be looking pretty good. And Sunwise decided not to go for any kind of GP10 item, has the Rejuvenation Bead and the Sightstone, which I really like, as against Leona, who's going to be locking you up at some point, you do need some kind of defense. If you're greedy and you rush straight for Nomad's Medallion, sure, it gives you sustain stats, but Leona doesn't care about your sustain. She will 100-0 you, particularly with a significant burst of Jinx, who is Sona Lisa, has now picked up the Super Mega Death Rocket, so her damage output will be pretty crazy. Up the top lane, Mendrix is still sitting with a tiny bit of a CS lead, but the longer this goes on, the harder Beast will be to take down without some intervention from Iron Woodsy or McNugget XD. Grandpa Sewer going to be chucking down a ward in the bush down here, and is sitting with about a 12 CS lead as well as the 1v1 kill. Shout out to Kinksy, who is post-game analysis and interview by Rec Game. That would be pretty cool. CS down to the bot, heavily in Sona Lisa's favor now after blue team were forced to back out. Sunwa looking pretty good on the CS, is 1 to Little Vayne 0 at the moment. Leona being forced back a little bit. Once she has the Solar Flare, her and her Ignite will be looking to get in there. It's interesting that Sunwa didn't take Exhaust against such strong threats as a Shyvana, Cannon, Jinx, because they're all fairly low range when Jinx is in her rocket form. So the exhaust would be quite easy to apply. Where is Idiot Q playing? Macca is playing AD carry this game, whereas the AD carry McNugget XD is still down the bottom lane, and actually Iron Woodsy going to be coming in from behind there. The purple team is not aware of this. They will be going in here. Sona Lisa does manage to avoid the charm, but the damage is still enough there. McNugget XD going to take a hit from the tower. Sunwa falling lower and lower, but does get out of tower aggro. It is being juggled very well by the blue team, and they do manage to juggle the tower aggro long enough to pick up a double kill. Meanwhile, the enemy jungler, OG Kush's Bruce V, will get a successful gank on Mendrix up at the top. The caster's curse coming down onto him, but the tower will not take very much damage, whereas Tang and Friends going to pick up the bottom lane, sitting 1400 gold in the lead at this point. Very good for them. Actually, Sona Lisa, looks like we got a super mega death rocket kill here. Let's follow it as it goes down. I can't imagine any other way for poor Sunwa to die. So super mega death rocket, as soon as it has that extra fire, it does hit the thing. Sunwa hits him right in the face. I think Lucian, if he'd been a little bit too far or a little bit closer, he would have fallen to that as well. Of course, the rocket does execute damage. Nearby enemies take 80% damage, so maybe Macca would have got out of that scot-free. But alas, the top tower will fall, so a quick comeback by OG Kush, only behind by a little bit. They're now down 200 gold, which is absolutely nothing. And of course, the towers were traded quite evenly, so the even game that we thought we'd get looks like it is indeed here. As Blinkster gonna be in the Twitch chat saying hello to Rec Game. Blinkster and Blake X, they're quite quite similar names there. Mendrick's going to be farming up at the top, going for the Sunfire, and it looks like the Murktread's actually going to miss some action in the mid, being very bad with that today. So we know that Bruce V going to be getting the jump on here. They have no idea that he is around. They're just going to be pushing, and then suddenly J4 out of nowhere. Beautiful Solar Flare lands by the Leona Little Vein, and McNugget XD may be going down. He flashes away. Do they have anything to follow up? Flash forward by Little Vein, and Bruce V gonna get the Dragon Strike off to finish that one. So 2-0 at the moment. Ignite goes down onto Bruce V, and that will definitely pick him up. Maka gonna flash forward, because why not? Sunwa forced to flash out of Beast. Beast almost has the Dragon Descent available. Barrier will not save Maka there, as Mendrix is going to be coming in 1v4. Can't do too much, particularly since he jumped onto the fairly tanky Shyvana. And that ends up being, I think, 3-4-1. In purple team's favor. They're now 1200 gold in the lead and have a very strong push going on in the mid lane here. Mendrix does have Dominus available, decides not to pop it. There he goes, but perhaps a little bit too late. Dragon's Ascent will go off, but a nice charm lands by Iron Woodsy, threading the needle there, and manages to get a return kill, which a nice pickup there. They return their gold deficient to 1200 gold as Dragon is up in 20 seconds. Looks like Tang and friends are ready and waiting to pick that one up. Purple team are working towards them there. Sunwa is going to run up to Little Vein. Ward goes down from the Leona, but instantly gets cleared out by the Sweeping Lens. Very smart to pick that one up once the Sightstone has been picked up. And Tang and friends are bang on the money with the Dragon Spawn. They're going to pick that one up for themselves. Sunwa zoning out the enemy team. Nice Stranglethorns. Going to make sure there's no Jinx in there. And Bruce V not able to get the steal. The Super Mega Death Rocket much too late. As Bruce V, will he actually manage to get out? No, does hit a charm in the end. And, oh, there's actually a little candy cane ward there. I'm not sure who picked that one up. We'll assume Sunwa, as, of course, supports are the only ones who ward at gold and below. And, oh, Blake is saying it's Bruce Vi. So if Bruce V or Bruce Vi, it definitely makes a lot more sense to be Bruce Vi, but Bruce V sounds like Bruce Lee, which is pretty cool. Maka being very, very bold here, trying to tempt Sona Lisa forward. Blue buff is successfully stolen away by Tang and friends. Both the Grasping Roots and the Cocoon will miss as Grandpa Cyril rushes his little Yordle way out of there. Looks like he's going for an Hourglass after picking up the Haunting guys. Cocoon will land onto Bruce Vi, but starting to look tankier and tankier. Looks like he's going for the Randuins, which I do not, I definitely agree with, between the Lucian and even Elise does okay auto attack damage, so Randuins will definitely cripple Maka in these fights. I do believe Relentless Pursuit breaks the Randuins buff though, because of course Lucian's dash does remove slows, which is tied into the Randuin slow. Beast going to be running forward. Only has level 1 in Dragon Descent, but will be going in. Grandpa Cyril is coming in, but will Beast survive? Gets locked up by Zera, and Maka barely makes it out by the skin of his teeth. Nice snipe by Grandpa Cyril there, getting the Thundering Shuriken in to make that a 1-for-1 with Maka barely living thanks to the support of the mages on his team. Mendrix has picked up the Sunfire Cape, going to be going for the Murktreads next. And shout out to Hovroll, who's saying my microphone is very quiet. Hopefully it's not too bad. The levels look decent to me, but it is a terrible microphone, so you never know. So Little Vein going to be headed down here to rendezvous with Sona Lisa. Going to stop to take out the candy cane. It is the season, after all, to take those down. The warding for the blue team, very good in their own jungle. Are they all trinket wards? That's what I want to know. No, it looks like they are actual wards. So Tang and friends being very good at dealing with the aggression of OG Gaming, which of course allowed them to pick off Beast in the previous fight, was a nice snipe by Grandpa Cyril to pick up the return there. Once he gets to level 2 in Slicing Maelstrom, he will have a big spike in the power. He's actually sitting on 1500 gold now, which I believe is close to enough for the Hourglass. He needs 1160 for Seekers and another 500. So he needs about 100 to pick up the Hourglass outright, which will And of course, with the Wombo combo you got going here, Little Vayne very good with the Solar Flares, you got Super Mega Death Rocket, you got Cataclysm, you even got the Initiation from Beast. The blue team are going to have to be very careful how they engage this one. They do have decent counter initiation, particularly Sunwa, very skilled with the Strangle Fawns, and even Cocoon and Charm, fairly good at stopping the fights. We've got the Purple Pings going on in here. Beast going to be locked up by the Charm for all of about half a second. I'm Woodsy going forward with the Spirit Rush, but it won't be doing too much there. The rest of the Purple Team milling around at the moment. Bruce Vi going to be running through the ward, and after all is said and done, Beast looking very healthy, and we have an Ahri without her ultimate. Didn't even have blue buff, so the 10% CDR will not benefit there. Shout out to Ashen17, who's pointing out my awful pronunciation of Zyra. I think it was Hello Reaper, who made me start saying Zyra. Maybe it was Luke. Someone says it really weird, and it's gotten into my head. It is Zyra, I'm pretty sure. That's how Freak says it in the spotlight, and Freak is never wrong. Ward's going to be going down by both teams there. Looks like the mid tower is under aggression from Tang and friends, but they don't want to commit too heavily, which of course is very smart, as soon as Solar Flare lands on at least two members, they'll be in a lot of trouble, so they've got to be careful how they siege this one. And the Elise McNugget XD not looking too tanky just yet, has a decent bit of health, but the resistances are very low, has gone for the Sork Shoes to augment the damage that she possesses. And so the Deathfire Grasp is available for I Am Woodsy. Is going to have Spirit Rush up very soon. Also has the Flash. Aggression coming forward by the OG Kush fellas, but it looks like they will disengage for now. They've got a lot of members sitting at about 10 or 9 in levels, so they want the level 2 ultimates if they possibly can. They actually have the only level 11 in the game, whereas the blue team, just as I say that, of course, I'm Woodsy going to hit the level 2 with the Spirit Rush. Tower falling lower and lower here between the Spiderlings and the plants. There is a lot of tankiness. Mendrix going to be jumping forward and nice engage by the purple team. Super Mega Death Rocket will come in. Grandpa Cyril going to be shut down there. Never went to go and get his Hourglass. Beast going to fall as well. And the Solar Flare is perfect, but it is a little bit too late. Double kill going the way of Mecha on the Lucian. And I did not expect that to turn around as it did. Sona Lisa, the sole survivor for the purple team. Brilliantly done by Tang and friends. The Wombo combo was so well done, just the damage was not there to take them down, and they will get the mid tower off of that fight. 3,000 gold in the lead. Dragon 10 seconds off spawning. They played that immaculately. You can see the culling will go out by Mecha and steals the blue away from I Am Woodsy, like all good AD carries do. Dragon will respawn just as looks like Tang and friends are going to decide to recall rather than risk sticking around, as Sona Lisa poking his or her head in, and momentary pause. Looks like we are going to be resuming though. And Mecha's girlfriend. Oh, we don't have colorblind on. I'm so sorry, Mecha's girlfriend. I didn't realize the colorblind mode was on. Oh, I Am Woodsy. Takes a zap to the face, but decides to ignore it. So, poor Sona Lisa not going to pick up any kills there, but we'll be able to get the dragon. I'm very sorry about that, guys. I don't know why colorblind mode went off. Hopefully that fixes it. There we go. My apologies for that one, guys. That should have been on. Apparently Mecha doesn't have a girlfriend according to Blinkster, so I am getting trolled a little bit. So now that purple is red and our colorblind friends can tell the difference, should be a lot more enjoyable for them. I apologize once again, guys. I had it set on red. I don't know why it changed itself to purple. Maybe it was with the patch. Haven't done too much casting since 3.15, so it wouldn't surprise me. The vision for the red team is it's actually going to be checked with the Super Mega Death Rocket. They know the Baron is available. Going to hit I Am Woodsy in Ahri shapely behind. And the aggression is onto the last standing tier 1 tower for OG. Kushmendrick is going to run up, tank that with his Cape of the Sun. And every tier 1 for the red team going to fall now. OG Kush falling a little bit behind. They executed that last fight almost perfectly. If the Solar Flare had been a little earlier, it may have worked out better for them. They end up 4-0 in the end, but they did manage to pick up the dragon, which helps them. and we have the entirety of their team around. Now, Hourglass is not actually ready for Grandpa Cyril, decided to go for the Sorcerer's Shoes for a little bit of movement speed and a penetration. And of course, they did need a little bit more damage, so I can agree with that decision. If the Solar Flare locks up Tang and friends for a little bit longer, it will be looking good. The engage goes off, Stranglethorns will go off, and it is fantastic. Bruce Fire gonna fall lower and lower, does end up falling, but Solar Flare is very well done, locks up Iron Woodsy, and Mac is channeling the culling right into the enemy's face. Leona tries to flash out, but it is not enough. Grandpa Cyril, will he end up falling to the Black Man Lucy? And he does indeed, as Iron Woodsy gonna flash forward and get the charm on, ends up being an ace with the fourth kill going to the Ahri, and 5-4-3 in the end, with about 3,500 gold in Tang and friends' pocket. With Sunwa only being level 9, going to respawn quite quickly, going for a bit of a damaging build himself. Actually picks up two Haunting Geysers, the penetration does not stack, so I guess he wants 50 AP and 400 health. As a shout out to Identikit, who I believe I've already shout out to. The infrastructure stands at 3-2, the only tier 1 remaining is the not so healthy tier 1 for Tang and friends down at the bottom lane. We'll have to see if OG Kush managed to get down there. Tang and friends doing a brilliant job of warding up the top part of the jungle. It's not quite as good at the bottom. There is a pink ward, which of course with the smart little places you can put pink wards, they can stay up a surprising amount of time. I think what's the bush where it's good? I'm just thinking maybe it's someone. There's a bush around this area that like never ever gets checked, but there's wards that are put near it. I'm dropping the ball on that one. So Beast, he does have the Spirit of Visage, and of course both the Sunfire Cape and the Spirit of Visage are going to get nerfed in the upcoming patch, as everyone and their mother is picking them up. We can see Mendrix on his way to his own Spirit of Visage. Randuin's getting closer and closer for Bruce Vi, is starting to pick up a little bit of magic resist as well, could be going for the Locket. I don't think Merc Treads would work with the Ancient Golem giving him Tenacity already. Locket would help a lot against the magic damage of Tang and friends. Dragon is a couple minutes off spawning, so that won't be a factor. Mecha down at the bottom lane has Bloodthirst and Triforce at the 23-minute mark. Engage gonna go on top of McNugget XD, and he will not escape that. And probably the best person to pick up that kill will indeed take it, Sona Lisa. And of course Jinx, pretty decent in the late game, certainly better than Lucian, so getting that kill for her is a big pickup. But the vision for Tang and friends will mean that they know that the Baron will be getting started, just as we see Shyvana launch a fireball towards it. And pause once again. What's he going to disconnect again? Shout out to XX Cub, who's trying to start things in the Twitch chat. Hopefully you guys take him inside and beat some sense into him. McNugget XD is down on the Elise. The Smite is not available, so it is very smart of OG Gaming to go for this one. There's not a whole heck of a lot that can steal the Baron, honestly. No, they don't really have the biggest burst damage. They've got decent, like, sustain damage. I think Macca on Idiot Q has the biggest chance of stealing, and he is making his way up from the base. He's just leaving the precipice of it now. Red team have a lot more ways to secure it. Of course, they've got Smite, which does 640 damage. Jinx does decent with the Super Mega Death Rocket as soon as the AoE goes in. And we are now coming back up Beast. Actually, it looks like they're trying to bait the Baron here. They're going to be... no, it's not baiting. They were just hesitating a little bit. The blue team is here, but OG Kush are well aware of it. Oh, nice work by Sunwa, locking up Sona Lisa, and the culling will go off Beast, going to jump straight onto Macca, but he is way too low. Mendrix picking up one kill, and Macca going to pick up another. That is three members going down very, very quickly. Bruce Fire will fall to a nice charm from I.M. Woodsy, who picks up his Rampage. Grandpa Cyril was the sole survivor of that one, and the Baron attempt did not go their way. The pause threw them off a little bit, I feel. Grandpa Cyril is here, though. Does have Slicing Maelstrom and Flash, so this could actually be quite bad for Tang and friends. Their Smite is on its way in the hands of McNugget XD. The flash in by Grandpa Cyril does not manage to hit Idiot Q with the the thundering shuriken, and it looks as though Baskabab may be headed the way of the Blue Team or Mecha falling low from the Super Mega Death Rocket, but he will last hit the Baron in the end as Sunwa Man, definitely the MVP of that fight. Locked up Sona Lisa with the Grasping Roots, laid down the Strangle Thorns in the Ignite, and that was all she wrote for Sona Lisa in that fight. Very well done by Tang and friends, going to take a quick maths, I think 7,000 gold in the lead with a Baron buff on the all-important Idiot Q, also known as Mecha. And he has the Triforce, and he has the Light Slinger, the Double Shot. So his tower pushing has just become very, very strong indeed. It's going to be down to OG Kush to try and pull it back as much as they can. 10 seconds left on the Dragon Spawn. They've got a really good Wombo combo team. They're just not pulling it off to absolute perfection. They just need some more items. You can see the idea here is Beast and Bruce Vi, or that's not Bruce Vi. So Beast and Bruce Vi go in. You have the slicing Maelstrom on top of that with the Solar Flare locking people up, and Super Mega Death Rocket to finish things up when everyone's low health. But they're not doing it the best so far. Little Vayne barely missing the Zenith Blade on the retreating Tang and friends there. As Mecha is currently 8-1-12, his fan club cheering him on to all new heights. Last Whisper being worked on by Sona Lisa, who has Static Shiv and the Bloodthirster for the Lucian. If you trade the Static Shiv for a Triforce, he is on relatively the same page. Actually, the CS for Sona Lisa is through the roof, to be honest. She has a huge amount of CS being followed by Beast on the Shyvana. Of course, that is one of Shyvana's strengths. She farms very, very quickly and is fairly mobile as well, so can get to the fights after clearing out the waves. Now, all of the cooldowns are available for the red team. Can they pull it off? They need to pick their opportunity carefully. The tier 2 is starting to fall lower, but they've got a little bit of a buffer here. And of course, when I say that, the tower went down. I was thinking, you know, there's not many minions there. Blue team may not be able to get it, but they do indeed. The tier 3 will stay up for now, as Plant does fall to the tower. Push gonna continue by Tang and friends. OG Kush are trying to find that opportunity. If the blue team dive under tower, I think it could be very, very hard for them, to be honest. Strangle Thorns will be very effective, but so will, you know, every ultimate for red team. So it's a fairly tense moment here. Even though 8,000 gold lead and Baron buff, the Tang and friends have got to be careful about how they do so. It looks like Mecha has said, everyone follow me, we're now taking bot, which gives the red team a little bit of room. If I were them, I'd certainly head down and try and defend the turret. It's sitting at a little bit over half its health. Beast heading up to the top to meet up with Mendrix, who definitely are brick walls at this point in time. Apparently GG game over, because Mecha is actually doing well in the game. As there is some illicit activities happening in the Twitch chat. Blue team going to be disengaging after, oh, looks like Sunwa going to pick up that white with his plant, so good for him. Any farm that the supports can get is worth it in my book. So waiting for Little Vayne to pick up the level 2 in the, oh sorry, yeah, the level 2 in the Solar Flare is going for the Chain Vest rather than Talisman of Ascension. Strangle Thorns will force the OG Kush guys off of their tower, which allows Tang and friends to take it down. We can see up at the top lane both falling very low. Dominus is still available, as Tang and friends going to be backing out now, putting the Baron to good use, taking down two tier 2s thus far. Beast going to be headed for the Blade of the Ruined King. Mendrix, does he have Brutalizer? How much gold is he sitting on at the moment? Has 1,500. Could go for the Brutalizer. May decide to go for Randuin's instead. Would definitely not blame him, as McNugget XD has picked himself up the Locket of the Iron Solari, which is incredibly useful against the AoE magic damage coming out from Lightning Rat McGrandpa Cyril. And yeah, so waiting for red team to get the engage that they want. Little Vayne definitely needs to try and steal a little bit of experience, needs to try and catch up so the Wombo combo can reach its maximum effectiveness. We're just waiting for Tang and friends to capitalize on the advantages they've got, because they have a stronger AD carry, that is OG Kush, So Tang and Friends, they've got, and it's very hard to dive a team with so much AoE. You've got Shyvana, who's just an AoE goddess. You've got Leona for the lockdown. You've got Jinx, who has long range, and then a executing ultimate. You've got Slicing Maelstrom, and you've got Cataclysm. It's so hard to dive against that. So Tang and Friends, like we said before, their sieging has to be very carefully done. Top tier 2 is actually falling quite low. So that could be a point for them to go for. I believe the Baron buff has run out. It has indeed. So, just waiting to see what they do now. They do not have the regen or the increased combat statistics that the buff offers. So, this may be them just pressuring the lanes and, you know, trying to starve the red team. Because as soon as they take an inhibitor, Jinx is just going to start getting even more free farm. And Sona Lisa is doing quite well on the farm already, honestly. Baron, 1 minute 20 off respawning. It looks like Tang and Friends know that they need that buff to come up, but they have arrived a little bit too early. They need to wait. Actually, Baron and Dragon have the exact same respawn at the moment, which is pretty cool. Dragon, of course, respawned in 6 minutes, Baron in 7. So Dragon must have died exactly a minute later, which of course it did because Sona Lisa was there to clear it out. Blue team going to try and do a little bit of bush humping here, but OG Kush being incredibly smart about this one, not running forward, as they're using all the advantages they get. This is OG Kush. They know the blue team is around. They just see Mendrix poke his head out here. The blue team going to be making their way around. We'll sit in all vision for now and find out exactly what is going to transpire here. It looks like the weak tier 2 at the top here will be the point of contention for Tang and Friends while they wait for the Baz Kebab to come back up, but they got to be careful. I don't know how many times I can say it. Although it looks like red team not going to try and defend this one. Bruce Vi forced to flash out after he gets locked up by the charm, which will lessen his initiation presence, and the Baron and Dragon both going to be spawning in a matter of seconds here. Bruce Vi is around, he does have the 720 damage smite. Blue team trying to stay in the bushes. There is no warning for the purple team. Trinket going to go on by Grandpa Cyril. That is very smart to make sure they are not flanked. Tang and Friends going to be headed down into the mid as red team heading back. And there's a lot of maneuvering around. Both these teams don't want to throw away the momentum that winning the first game of a series can bring you. Maka's girlfriend goes back to the pink text. Good for, well, hopefully good for her, but it may be good for him. Baron is going to be abandoned by Tang and Friends at the moment, as OG Gaming, oh, they could potentially catch out Maka here, but Bruce Vi has been baited forward by the very scrumptious looking Lucian and ends up falling to the pickoff potential of Blue. Maka will actually force the flash out of Sona Lisa, the culling not going to do the most damage. Beast, oh, actually he will end up getting the kill by relentlessly pursuing forward and throwing out the piercing light, and that may be the beginning of the end here, as the red team could not get the engage that they needed. Tier 3 will get destroyed by the Spidlings and plants tanking it up. And, of course, Idiot Q, otherwise known as Maka, is being an absolute monster on the Lucian. He did lock it in first for a reason, and we can see that why now. I'm actually wondering if Maka and McNugget XD, like, They were supposed to trade and they ended up not trading, or it didn't work or something, because that could happen, or if what they're doing now is planned, because it's certainly working. Maka showing his skill on the Lucian. He is not just a Lee Sin man, which is fair enough. Party Ensign, I guess you could say OG Kush got smoked. I don't actually get that one, but maybe someone else understands it. Is there anyone who smokes there? No, I don't think so. Baron is being worked on by Tang and Friends, falling lower and lower. Little Vayne, will he get the ward into the pit? Will Zap go out? Will they get any kind of vision at all? Bruce Vi falling lower and lower to the poke. Baron gonna get abandoned there. Bruce Vi will end up falling as he does get the knock up. But Culling is just doing a ridiculous amount of damage. Beast gonna try and Dragon's Ascent in, but it is too late. I am Woodsy, the only one who has gone down. And the blue team gonna go straight for the finisher here. Grandpa Cyril was down at the bottom. Could not assist with his team, as Little Vayne just going to be waiting around. Sunwa gonna try and take him down, gets a little bit of the bandit gold, but I think this may be all she wrote for game one here, with the Idiot Q being, carrying on his thick, manly, black man shoulders. How is Sun One, Little Vayne doing? Looks like they're having a little bit of a dance back and forth. Will Little Vayne end up going down? They're going to have a support 1v1. Sun One forced to flash away from the Eclipse as the Nexus will end up exploding. And Tang and friends take a very important game one. Ashen 17 put sunglasses, yeah. And we still don't know where that joke was going. So, very well done by Tang and friends to pick up the first game here. We're definitely going to have to hand MVP to Idiot Q, who, let's check exactly how he wants it. Idiotech. Okay. So, well done to Macca / Idiotech or Idiot Q for picking up the MVP with a very well done Lucian. Unfortunate for AOG Kush, they certainly had the early game down, they were responding beautifully, but that fight where they locked up the enemy team and did not get a single kill, that really spelled the demise out for them there. They executed their combo well, they just were not far ahead enough to have the damage to actually turn that initiation into a successful fight. So we will be back with game two momentarily here, ladies and gents. Hopefully I have a co-caster with me, and we'll have to see if Tang and friends can walk away with the victory in a 2-0 sweep of the Gold Coast Tournament Grand Finals, or do OG Gaming have a final trick up their sleeve? This is Cold Blood, signing out for now.